So, a very warm welcome to everyone who joins us today on a Monday. A little bit gray here in Berlin, but I think we will see some light today, starting with the agenda, with a very, very good presentation called BNG Blaster, an open source network tester. This is a project which is hosted at GitHub by company Artibricks. Project managers are Christian Giese and István Rutzmann. And we can give a very warm welcome to Christian, who will give us some insights to this project and will do a presentation in a few seconds. So some words about Christian. Christian is a software developer and field service engineer at Artibricks. Before he started his journey at Artibricks almost 3 years ago, he was working 7 years as a professional service consultant for access, core, and automation at Juniper Networks. But his actual networking career started earlier in the BNG department of German Telekom, or in German Deutsche Telekom AG, formerly known as Zentrum Technik Einführung. Over the last decade, he was an inherent part supporting Deutsche Telekom AG to build the access and core network infrastructure. Before we start the presentation, I would like to ask you kindly to raise your questions inside the questions channel. There will be some minutes time after the talk to answer your questions. So now the stage is yours, Christian. Enjoy.
Yeah, thanks for this nice introduction. And I'm very happy to talk here about my favorite open source project, the BNG Blaster. But before I go into the details, let me shortly explain what we do and why we decided to build a complete new open source network test software from scratch. So here at Artibricks, we build carrier grade software for off-the-shelf bare metal switches. Artibricks full stack takes advantage of the latest merchant silicon like the Broadcom Q2C, running on high performance bare metal switches to give you high performance at a fraction of cost of conventional monolithic router systems. We are also the first and currently only vendor with a disaggregated approach connected to the Deutsche Telekom AG core network as part of the Access 4.0 project. Not enough, we also built a fully working disaggregated BNG in compliance to the strict regulations of the German market. But first, what is a BNG? And to answer this, a BNG, or called a broadband network gateway, is the service creation for residential internet access. And this sounds not that complicated, but if you ask 100 ISPs how they build residential internet access, you will possibly get 200 different answers. And such a service creation is built out of multiple, let's call it legacy protocols. Protocols which are often, I would say, some kind of abused for purposes different than the original intended for this protocol. Protocols, an example like DHCP v6, which was designed for Ethernet. But if you use DHCP v6 within a PPPoE session, then the implementation has to be slightly different. And also PPP itself was actually not designed for the as the client-server protocol it is used today. And obviously, if you have a lot of legacy protocols and they are all accessible by millions of untrusted CPE devices, then this requires also a lot of testing in regards to security and hardening. In Germany, such a service creation, or let's say residential internet access, is mandated by the Federal Network Agency, or in German, the Bundesnetzagentur. And this includes a lot of strict requirements regarding accounting accuracy, legal interception, as well as boot cell services. And here in Germany, all the residential customers have the freedom to bring their own CPE. And this requires a BNG protocol stack to be able to handle, let's say, hundreds of different client implementations from vendors like AVM, Huawei, Acadian, Sitesil, OpenVRT, Juniper, and so on and so on. And all their client implementations are a bit differently and sometimes also a bit strange, or not to say wrong. But if a CPE is out in the market and used by millions of customers, and it was working before, you cannot argue that the CPE is doing it wrong. And therefore, a BNG protocol stack has to be built, of course, in compliance to all the standards, but also optimized for a maximum of interoperability with all those unknown number of client devices in the market. And therefore, building a disaggregated BNG, or in general, building a BNG, requires a lot of protocol testing and also to test all the different flavors of all those protocols. And this is where the BNG Blaster comes into play. But why do we build our own network tester? Because you could also buy something from the market, commercial solution. And of course, we started with a commercial network tester. But we got increasingly frustrated because of missing features and unrealistic client behaviors, as well as a lot of limitations in regarding to automation. A good example here was the software we used. If you emulate PPPoE sessions with DualStack, this software, it was a commercial software, but I will not name it. This software first starts all the PPPoE sessions, negotiates IPv4, IPv6, and if all sessions are up, then it starts negotiating DHCPv6. But this is completely unrealistic because a real CPE will not wait for other CPEs before it asks for a DHCP address. And this is just one of the examples which gets us frustrated, because these kind of timing behaviors can hide some of the bugs, and then you are completely frustrated if you see this first time in your production network. And then, not worth talking about the enormous costs as well as the license restrictions of commercial network test software and hardware. And yeah, starting with IPTV, we are faced with the decision to invest into a new software or test hardware, because the virtual test platform we used before wasn't able to be used for IPTV testing. IPTV here means IGMP over a PPP session, which is optimized for fast join and leave as required for channel zapping. And then we had the decision to buy something new from the market or to build our own. And obviously we decided for second, otherwise I would not talk about it here. And after 2 weeks after this decision, the first prototype of the BNG Blaster was already working, and we are able to set up thousands of PPPoE sessions. And then it took us further 2 weeks to get our IPTV tests up and running. And with this success, then we continuously improved the BNG Blaster until we could migrate all our protocol test cases from the commercial or the existing commercial test platform to the BNG Blaster. Therefore, we also built a BNG Blaster controller with some corresponding robot keywords, as we use robot for our test automation. And but this project is not yet released to the public. But if you are interested in the BNG Blaster as well, you can also send us a mail to bngblaster@artipric.com to possibly get some early access here. But we definitely plan to publish this as well. Another big challenge of network testing for a BNG was L2TP, because none of the commercial test platforms is able to properly emulate an LNS in regards to our demands. And of course, we could buy just a Cisco or Juniper LNS as other vendors or customers are doing, but this would only prove that our software works with a Cisco or Juniper LNS. And L2TP defines a lot of optional behaviors and flavors how you can do L2TP. And if you check different solutions in the market, so like Cisco, Juniper, also Junos E and Junos, they also behave a bit different. Alcatel, which is now Nokia, then you see they all behave a bit different in L2TP. And definitely we cannot buy all of the LNSs in the market to test if our software works correctly. And then we decided to add L2TP LNS support here as well. being able to emulate all the protocol flavors and all the options for the variable HTTP header format here. Yeah, and currently we have migrated all our access test cases from the commercial test platform to the BNG Plaster, and we are working to add more and more routing features here as well, to do also BGP ICS testing or some MPLS tests on the BNG Plaster. So, but what can you do with the BNG Plaster? So today the BNG Plaster allows you to do a lot of networking and BNG tests on high scaling with a very slow CPU and memory footprint. So we could easily emulate 100,000 PPPoE sessions on a single BNG Plaster instance with more than 1 million packets per second and traffic flows. And there's actually no hard limit in the packets per second or in the performance or in the traffic flows. But of course, depending on your actual hardware, you could get higher or lower scaling. In example, for 16,000 PPPoE sessions, we need around 300 megabytes of memory. So which is where some of the commercial softwares already talk about 4 to 8 gigabytes, depending on the solution. Our software also runs on every modern Linux. So it only works on Linux because we use the Linux packet mmap interface for receiving traffic. So it's the same interface the TCP dump is using. And yeah, it works in every virtual machine or container. And the good news is it doesn't use DPDK. So you can really install it on your development PC and every VM or where you like, and can use it on every interface type. It also works on a Vite interface, and then you can send traffic from a Vite interface to one of your test setups. The BNG Plaster supports PPPoE and IPoE. IPoE is nothing else than internet access via DHCP, so just basic IP access. And with different flavors like end-to-one and one-to-one VLAN mode, it supports IPTV, meaning IGMP version 1 to 3, with automatic channel zapping tests, as other vendors are also doing. It supports L2DP emulation. And a very nice feature, it supports also cross testing. And cross you can do for subscriber sessions. So meaning you can define, you can say, okay, automatic generate some traffic streams as you define them for every session. And then you can measure the receive and send rate, the loss, as well as minimum and maximum latency and many more. And all this, but you can also define some raw traffic streams if you would like to test some networking, or like a good thing, something we do here is we use the BGP Plaster, which is also something you can find in our GitHub space. It's nothing more than a fork of BGP dump 2, able to also send the MTR files we can download via BGP to our switches. And then we use the same MTR files to generate traffic streams for the BNG Plaster. And then we can send 1 million routes or a BGP full table completely via BGP. And then also generate 1 million flows with the BNG Plaster between two interfaces and verify if all the routes are installed correctly into the forwarding plane. And we also measure the time it takes until they are installed in the forwarding plane. Because you all know there's a difference between we have learned 1 million routes and 1 million routes are working. And this is where the BNG Plaster is able to help you. So, and of course, cross-testing for raw traffic and session traffic. Depending on your setup, we could easily utilize a 10 gigabit interface, but also a 40 gigabit interface should be working with the BNG Plaster. But depending on the packet size, obviously not 40 gigabit with 64 byte packets. And so what I have tested is around up to 5 million packets per second with the BNG Plaster. But I was not using, let's say, the latest CPU generation. Then, as I mentioned before, automation, you can use the BNG Plaster, but you can easily build your own wrappers for the BNG Plaster or ask us to get access to the BNG Plaster controller. So, but I think this was enough theory about the BNG Plaster. So let's show some of the, or let's show the BNG Plaster in action. So therefore I built a very small demo on my development PC. So I was running a virtual BNG with our Agipik full stack software in a container on my VM. So I have a Linux VM running with Ubuntu, and then there run is a Agipik full stack BNG container. It's an LXC container running, and then I have here some vite interfaces between the BNG cluster to generate some sessions and some traffic. So no. Then first take a look if the BNG is up, so we can see the radio server is in a counting state up, and right now there is no session active. And then we can first check the configuration we will test. So a minimum configuration you can use with the BNG cluster is a very short JSON file like this. This would be the bare minimum to test, and which then definitely it automatically uses in all the defaults we have defined. But the default values are very, let's say, realistic values. You could do a very serious testing with the defaults, I mean. And but for this demo, I will use a bit more advanced configuration. And here I define first a network interface. A network interface is an interface you can directly connect to the device under test, or you can place somewhere in the core network, which has the advantage if you place it somewhere in your core network that you can prove that the convergence to your network is also working. So an example, if you advertise the subscriber routes as host routes instead as aggregates. Then we have multiple VLAN ranges here, which can be connected to a different or to the same physical interface. You can see here I'm using vite interfaces. And here I use different authentication protocols. So this is a setup where I can test pub and shub in parallel. And then I assign stream and access line profiles here. So first I define the general access line, which is the line ID or agent remote ID with some iterators here. And then I have an access line profile. I can have multiple access line profiles. So which is the information you typically receive from the ENSA via PPPoE intermediate agent. Then I define the session traffic. This is this feature I mentioned before that the BNG cluster automatically generates flows for the IPv4, IPv6, and IPv6 delegated prefix learned for the session and between the session and the network interface. Then I can set a username and password with some iterators. And then at the end, I also generate streams like a best effort stream and a voice stream in bidirectional, which is then assigned to the session. So you can see here stream group ID 1, and here also I say stream group ID 1, and then they are automatically attached. I define a packet length, and because this is a virtual setup on my VM, I just use 1 PPS for now, plus the 3 PPS here from the session traffic. This should end up in 5 BPS per direction per session. So then we can, yeah, let's do this manually. So sudo bng cluster. So first, let's see, bng cluster is here, and we have also a lot of options here. So we can provide a config. We can also provide the traffic streams as a separate file, because if it has BGP and if it file with, let's say, 1 million traffic flows, it's easier if you have this in a separate file. You can define some log files, and you can define the number of sessions and a few more things you can override interactively. So then I start with the config file, which is a ppoe.json. I say, let's say, use just pandas and sessions for now, generate a report at the end. Then I will, what do I need? Then I will generate a control socket. I will show also later the control socket is required to do some get some runtime information out of it. So it's just a Unix domain socket, which is used as a JSON RPC interface between a CLI or in our case the BNG cluster controller to the BNG cluster itself. And then I run this in the interactive mode, and the interactive mode means that it will open an nCurses UI for you. And we decided for nCurses here because in every lab I'm able to get access to switches via SSH. And then, yeah, nCurses works and we have a nice UI instead of a web UI. But you can also, the default mode is just locking lines. But yeah, in courses, a lot of people like, and I also like to work with this in an interactive mode. And yeah, I think that's that should be all. And then we can start. And then you can see, maybe I have to reduce the size a bit, the stream. So, and then, yeah, okay. So here you can see the sessions. I have 1,000 sessions, and already 1,000 sessions are established. Then you see DHCPv6. We also have 1,000 DHCPv6 bindings. And then we see the call setup rate here, and we see the traffic flows. And this is what I mentioned before. We have three IP addresses, two directions, which means six flows per session, 1,000 sessions. So we have 6,000 traffic flows automatically generated with one packet per second. So we have then 3,000 packets per second up and downstream. And we have a voice and best effort defined for every session, which is also then up and downstream for four flows. And at the end, we should have 10,000 packets per second, 5,000 per direction. And this is, you can also see here below, we have 5,000 packets per second TX and RX rate. We see no loss, and lossy is measuring also using the BNG cluster header, because every packet has a unique flow identifier and a sequence number, 64-bit sequence number, so that we can identify packet loss here. So then we can go to next view. Here we can see some protocol statistics. Here we can see the packet status, packet sent and received. Here we can see that the LCP packets are increasing because we have Echo Keep Alive enabled. We can see that we receive IGP messages from the BNG because it is working as a query. And we can see also very fast if we have some timeouts. Here we have seen some IP6CP timeouts, which is okay in this case. And yeah, then we can go to the next view, which is session and streams. Here we can also go through all the sessions, and we can see the state of the sessions and the packets per second on the session interface. And for every stream, we can see packets per second and if we have seen loss or not. So, but that's not all. So we open this with a socket, so we can then also use the socket to get some runtime information. So we can say, so we can use it, or BNG Blaster CLI script, connect to the socket, and let's say first command session info, session ID 1, and take a look on the time. Okay, that's good. So then I get the information about the session very detailed, like the DHCP state, IPv4, IPv6 states, the IP addresses learned, and also the information about the session traffic. And I can also do some kind let's say session streams, which is then voice and best effort. And then I see here also voice best effort up and downstream for this particular session. Here you can, very important for testing, is the RX TOS and outer and inner VLAN bit, because then I can send my traffic and can check if my remarking routes are working, and this in an automated manner, which is a feature which was completely missing for a lot of platforms. Here you can also see that I'm running on a virtual platform with a lot of read interfaces, because I have enormous bad jitter. On a hardware platform, you don't have this jitter problems, but I'm running on the same VM, the Plaster, the BNG, the VPP, and some other tools. So then jitter isn't optimized. This is in nanoseconds here. And yeah. Then what the BNG Plaster is also able to do is, as I mentioned before, it uses the packet mmap interface, and which same interface TCP dump is using. So if you, which means that you can start it with the option minus P and then put a file, and then all the packets we receive via packet mmap, we automatically write into a pcap file for you, which is a combined pcap file for all interfaces here. So let's say you have the maximum of 32 physical interfaces. Let's say we have 32 interfaces, and at the end it generates you one pcap with all the interfaces, and you can unfilter on the interface name in the pcap. And then also this saves a lot of performance instead of running two times a packet mmap socket. If I stop the test, I just need to control C or press F9 or send the command. Then I get at the end a nice summary report with here I see an example, the convergence times, the traffic's verified. I see the delays, latencies as summary, but I also have the report at the end. And I can also enable some flags to get more information into the reports. So it's very flexible, and I hope it's quite good documented on GitHub. But of course, the documentation can ever be better, as for any open source project. So then let me switch back here. And I think we have still 4 minutes for questions.
Okay. Thank you very much. This was an awesome presentation, like my American friends normally phrase it. Very interesting to see how much effort and how much work is inside this project. So we have some questions. Your guess was right. Starting with the highest voted question, how many different devices and software combinations did you have under test in high times in the lab?
We test right now. We have three platforms, hardware platforms, which is QMX, Q2C, and QAX. We have to test, and we have different vendors like Eufy Space and EdgeCore, as well as Delta. And then you already figure out that we have a lot of permutations of devices where we have to test, and we also run overnight hundreds of different virtual topologies with the BNG cluster. So like the setup you have seen here, so for control plane testing or BGP testing, we also run hundreds to thousands of tests in the night, for every night. And this was also one reason why commercial software isn't working, because I can, if I need, let's say, 100 test instances overnight, I have to buy 100 license seats. And in average, I need maybe 10, but if I need 100, I can easily spend $1 million for licenses. And this wasn't working for us.
Okay, thank you. Can the BGB Blaster also test and validate CGN setups?
CGN setup, it's a good question. I have not used it for this, but I guess it could be easily, you can use it for testing, of course, but I think you can easily extend the flow tracking feature to do dedicated CGN tests. The problem is right now all the flows are UDP, which isn't optimized here. But we are already thinking about to add TCP streams here, and then this would allow better CGN testing, because we can then track the ports received sent. And I think it's not a big effort here, but first we need TCP here, and we already plan to use LWIP and do TCP streams as an addition.
I think we have time for two more questions. What is the maximum number of parallel sessions possible? My last try crashed the Linux kernel at about 12,000. And as my question was from Lutz.
Actually, there is no hard limit. And the Linux kernel is, what we do here is a complete kernel bypass. So the kernel isn't the problem here, only the maximum packets per second on the CPU performance. So the actual session state machine is running in a single main thread. But I guess if you have, let's say, state-of-the-art CPU, we could possibly also have more than 128,000 sessions, maybe also 200,000 sessions. But let's say the maximum BNG you can buy in the market supports 128,000 PPPoE sessions. And I think with a state-of-the-art CPU, you can test this.
So one very short answer, please, on the last questions. There seems to be some fuzzing code in the repository, which I think would be very interesting. Anything you can share about that?
Yes, we use AFL, the well-known Google project, for fuzzing our protocol implementations. So as mentioned before, we implemented all protocols from scratch, from Ethernet to PPP, everything we have re-implemented here. And then we have done fuzzing tests here. And we use the same approach we also use for our actual software on fuzzing. And this is the AFL. It's a good blueprint. If you would like to start with AFL testing, you can check out the AFL testing code, because we added some features that ensures that also if we just read one byte more than the buffer is, that guarantee crashes, because it doesn't guarantee crash if you just read one byte more. But we added some memory sanitizers here. And it's a very good blueprint if you would like to test your own libraries. If you use this example from BNG Blaster, that's fine. And then you can do some fuzzing here.
So, Christian, we are running out of time. There were a lot of more questions here. I hope you will be available in the channel somewhere or in a direct chat message. I hope we can also see you in the social in the evening. Please write down your questions and ask Christian. I think he will be happy to answer them for you. So thank you for joining for the first session in the afternoon on Monday. And clap your hands again for Christian. It was really a very, very good talk, a very good presentation. And so we are out and waiting for the next presentation.